Good morning, students. Welcome to Standard 11. I am Mrs. Shanta Kumari. I am going to teach you maths. Hope you will be enjoy this year along with me. Before we are moving to the lesson, I am just giving you an example. Suppose if you are walking 2 kilometers from your house to school. Okay? So, but it takes 30 minutes, then we can find out the speed, how fast you are walking. So speed, how can we find out? Distance divided by time taken. This is the usual thing. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to find out the smallest change. So that means it may be a fraction of second, or it may be the smaller, that is fraction of a minute even. So whatever it is we are finding, that smaller one is nothing but derivative. I am giving you one more example. If a car is moving from one place to another, suppose if it takes 2 hours to cover 100 kilometers. Within 2 hours it covers 100 kilometers. But what we are going to find out is the smallest change. Within that 2 hours, it may be 0.25, it may be 0.00001. So that smallest change is nothing but there is a change in time. So that is velocity is equal to delta S by delta T. But the delta S is the smallest displacement. Delta T represents the smallest time taken. So it may be starts from the zero value to 2 hours. But we are considering only the smallest portion. That is called derivatives. Differentiation. What is differentiation? The process of finding derivative of a function is called differentiation. Okay. So, I just give you an example. If I have y is equal to f of x. What is that f of x? Y is a function of x. So, that means for example, if I take y is equal to x to the power 4. Are any trigonometric functions, maybe sin x, cos x, tan x or anything else. Or I may be having it as 4 into x to the power 2. So if I am having a function with respect to x, if it is there, then we can differentiating it with respect to x. Because my right side is a function of x, therefore I can differentiate it with respect to x. This one can be denoted as dy by dx is equal to f dash of x. Your y's differentiation is taken as dy by dx and f of x is f dash of x. Okay. For example, if I'm taking a square, the area of a square is taken as y. I just taken like that. So now the dimensions are taken as x and x because it is a square. So now what is the area of a square? Area of a square is equal to x square. So I am taking y equal to x square. So now what I am going to do is, I am going to do some smaller changes in the dimensions. So if I am taking the smaller changes, so you just see these blue color lines, this is the extra dimension. That is, if I am taking 4 centimeter, I am just taking 4.01 centimeter like that. A smaller change in that. So that smaller change represents dx. So now this whole area is taken as, what is that? Dy. So if I am taking that, then that is equal to dy. So now what I am going to do is, I am just to separate these changes. Okay, so now I'm going to separate it as three kind of rectangles. So the first one is, the dimensions of the first one is x dx, and the dimensions of the second one is again dx and dx, and the dimension of the third one. What is the third one? Here I can get it in the form of a square, therefore it will be dx and dx. Now we are going to find out all these areas. So now what is the change in area? Change in area is equal to first one's area is x dx plus second one's area is x dx plus the third one's area is dx the whole square, because it is in the form of multiplication. That is, we have to take a square's area. Now, supposing I am just taking dx is equal to 0.01. It is the smaller one. If I am squaring that, then I will get 0.0001. So that means it is negligible. So we are approximating it to 0. So I can get only dy is equal to 2x dx. So shall I bring that dx down? Then dy by dx is equal to 2x. Therefore, if I have y is equal to x square, then what is my differentiation? Dy by dx. Okay, let me see one more example. Suppose I am taking a cube. So cube, what is volume of a cube? Y is equal to x cube. If I am taking dimension is equal to x. Now I just take that dx is the change in dimension, a smaller change. So if I am taking the smaller change from this, I can get 3 cubic areas, cubic values. Cubic means volume. Here we can get, that is x square dx and x square dx. All the other things are negligible because it is approximated to 0. Therefore, we can get it as the value equal to dy by dx is 3x square. Therefore, if I get y is equal to x cube, then dy by dx is nothing but 3x square. So here what I am doing for the first one, I have just y is equal to x square. So I just bring that 2 down. It becomes dy by dx is 2x. So now what here we are having, y is equal to x cube. Therefore, if I am taking the value, then 3 is down. I am reducing the power by 1. So if I'm going to do that, then I can find out the general expansion is, if my y is equal to x to the power n, then dy by dx is nothing but n into x to the power n minus 1. Just I'm taking the power and reducing the power by 1. Okay. Now, for example, if I take y is equal to 2 into x to the power 5. So then what is the differentiation? I just bring that 5 down. But you just look at this, 2 is a coefficient. Therefore, I am keeping the coefficient as it is. And x to the power 5 can be written as 5 into x to the power 4. So now shall I multiply these two? Then if I am multiplying, I am getting the answer is 10 into x to the power 4. I just reduce the power by 1. For example, if I am having y is equal to some constant k, then what is the difference between constant and coefficient? Coefficient means it lies along with the variable. Constant means there is no variable, only a number. So the differentiation of constant is equal to 0. For example, if I take y is equal to minus 12, whatever it is, positive or negative, what is my differentiation? Which is equal to 0. Even I may take a larger number. For example, if I take y is equal to some 23,456, what is my differentiation? That is equal to 0. Similarly, if I have an exponentiation, exponentiation means e to the power. So if I have y is equal to e to the power x, then my differentiation is nothing but e to the power x. The same. E power x means e power x is my differentiation. For example, if I am taking y is equal to e to the power ax, I have a coefficient for x, then my differentiation will be a into e power ax. That is, that coefficient will come in before and write the exponentiation as it is. For example, if you are having y is equal to e power 3x, then what is the differentiation? Yes, 3 into e power 3x. Okay, so now let me do some other differentiations in trigonometric values. But these trigonometric values you should practice. So now y is equal to sine x means the differentiation is dy by dx is equal to cos x. Suppose if I have y is equal to cos x, then my differentiation is minus sine x. If I have y is equal to tan x, then my differentiation is secant square x. If I have y is equal to cosecant x, because cosecant is a reciprocal of sine, dy by dx is nothing but minus cosecant x cot x. If I have y is equal to secant x, then my differentiation is secant x tan x. If y is equal to cot x, then dy by dx is minus cosecant square x. And again, if I am having y is equal to logarithm, then my differentiation is 1 divided by x. That is the differentiation of logarithm. Supposing I have an inverse function, 1 by x, then its differentiation is minus 1 by x square. Okay, if it is in the form of denominator, instead of reducing the power, we have to raise the power by 1 and take the negative value of that power. Okay, so these are all the important formulas in differentiations. You should learn these things. Okay, now let me do some exercise problems. Okay, so if I'm going to do some problems, I'm just taking the first one, f of x is equal to x minus sin x. So now I have to differentiating with respect to x. What is that w dot r dot 2? That means I'm differentiating with respect to. The short form of that is w dot r dot 2. Okay. Always we have to differentiate it with respect to the right side variable. What is the right side variable given here? X. I have a function x and the second term is nothing but sin x. So if I'm differentiating that, then I will get x differentiation is 1 and sin x differentiation is cos x. I just write that minus. So 1 minus cos x. For example, if I'm taking next problem, f of x is equal to sin x plus cos x. How can I differentiate? I have to differentiate with respect to the right side. Right side, what is the variable I am having? X. So differentiating with respect to x. What is the differentiation of sin x? Cos x. Differentiation of cos x is minus sin x. Therefore, f dash of x is nothing but cos x minus sin x. Now, if I have a function with some other variable, f of t is equal to 4 into secant t plus tan t. So now I have to differentiate with respect to what? What is my right side? T. Therefore, I have to differentiate it with respect to t. So if I'm differentiating with respect to t, then f dash of t is equal to what is secant's differentiation? Secant t tan t. That 4 is a coefficient which is not a constant. That means that is not equal to 0. So I am just writing 4 secant t tan t plus tan t's differentiation is secant square t. Okay. So now, children, if you are not practicing these differentiations, it will be very difficult for you. If you are practicing that, it will be easy for you. So I am going to give you some practicing problems. So what are they? I just gave only 3 problems. You just do it. F of x is equal to x power 6. F of x is equal to 5x power 7 minus 2x square. And f of x is equal to e power x plus sin x minus 2 tan x. So these are all the 3 problems I have given. You just work it out and see. Our friends are here to explain the next problem. Listen that carefully.
F of x is equal to 4 into x to the power 7. Now we are going to differentiate with respect to x. If I am differentiating it with respect to x, I have to bring the power down. So it becomes 4 sevens are 28 into x to the power 6.
F of t is equal to 3 into t power 3 plus 4 t square plus 6. Here I have to differentiate with respect to t. Therefore, f dash of t is equal to 3 threes are 9 into t square. I have to reduce the power by 1. Then plus 4 twos are 8, 8 into t.
G of x is equal to secant x plus x cube. Differentiating with respect to x gives me g dash of x is equal to, for secant x differentiation, secant x tan x. X cube's differentiation, I am bringing the power down, so 3, I am reducing 1 power, it becomes x square. So secant x tan x plus 3x square.
F of x is equal to e to the power 5x plus sin x plus 5. If I am differentiating with respect to x, then f dash of x is equal to 5 into e power 5x. Because 5 is a coefficient, I should write it down. So 5 e power 5x plus sin x differentiation is cos x and the constant's differentiation is 0.
F of x is equal to log x minus 4x plus 10. If I'm differentiating with respect to x, logarithm's differentiation is 1 by x and x differentiation is 1. So 1 by x minus 4, 10 is a constant, constant's differentiation becomes 0. H of t is equal to 2 tan t minus 5 t cube minus 2000. Because I have the right side variable is t, I have to differentiate with respect to t. So h dash of t is equal to tan t's differentiation is secant square t, therefore 2 secant square t minus 5 3's are 15 and I have to reduce the power by 1, it becomes t square. And 2000 is a constant, constant's differentiation is 0.
See. Thank you, children.